In this video, I'll guide you on detecting location changes in .NET MAUI. We'll display the coordinates on the homepage and send them to a server in real time. This data enables real-time viewing of device location. Let's begin. To access location, we'll enable the necessary permissions. For Android testing, enable Access Course Location and Access Find Location. For iOS, add permissions like NS Location when in use usage description in info.plist. Next, we'll install the necessary NuGet packages. First, I'm installing communitytoolkit.mvvm. Then, I'm installing stackexchange.redis to send location details to the server. If you're using a different method, install the appropriate libraries for that. I'll be using Redis streaming functionality for real-time data transmission. There are various other messaging services available, so choose one that fits your specific requirements. Let me know in the comments which services you typically use. Before continuing, I'd like to mention that we've added this source code to our Patreon community where you can download and refer to it. Now, let's create a folder named Services. Inside that folder, I'll create a class named Location Sync Service, which is responsible for listening to location changes and notifying other components, like the UI and the service for sending data to the server. In this service, we'll add a method which will start listening for location changes. We'll assign a method to the geolocation location changed event, so it gets called whenever the location changes. Next, we'll create a geolocation listening request, specifying the accuracy as the first parameter. I'll set the minimum time between location updates to 1 second, but you can adjust this according to your needs. If the request is not null, we'll start listening by providing the request as a parameter. The start listening foreground async method returns a Boolean value, which will be true if it started listening successfully. We'll assign this value to a private variable. Next, let's create a method to stop listening. Here, we'll detach the method from the location changed event and use the stop listening foreground method. Once stopped, we'll set the isListening value to false. Now, let's implement the method that will be triggered when the location changes. In the event arguments location property, you can see many values we can fetch. For this demonstration, we just need latitude and longitude. I'll create a new model class inside a new folder named Models. In this model class, we'll have two properties, latitude and longitude. We'll also include a constructor that accepts these two values and assigns them to the properties. When the event is triggered, we'll create a new object of the device location model, providing latitude and longitude as parameters. Then, we'll use the weak reference messenger, a messaging system that enables communication between different parts of the application. Using the send method, we'll send this device location object as a message. It's important to create a message class that represents the information we need to send. The message class should inherit from value changed message of device location. In the constructor, we'll receive the object as a parameter and pass it to the base class. Next, let's create a folder to keep the view model. I'll create a class named MainPageViewModel. For more information on view models and the MVVM pattern, you can refer to our video, which is part of our .NET MAUI tutorial series. The link is available in the video description. We'll inherit the class from ObservableObject. Then, let's declare latitude, longitude, and isListening as private variables. Additionally, we'll add a variable for the button text, so we can use the same button for both starting and stopping the listening process. We'll add the observable property attribute to all the properties. In the class constructor, we'll obtain the location sync service object and assign it to a private read-only object. Next, we'll use weak reference messenger to register for device location messages. When a message is received, we'll update the latitude and longitude variable values with the received values. Initially, the button text will be start. Next, we'll create a method to start and stop listening for location changes. In this method, we'll first check if isListening is false. If it is, we'll start listening by calling the start method in our service, change the value of isListening to true, and update the button text to stop. In the else statement, we'll stop listening for location changes and change the isListening value and button text accordingly. We'll provide the relay command attribute so that we can bind this method to the button. On the main page, I've designed the UI with the necessary bindings. We display the latitude and longitude in a grid view. In the MAUI program class, I've added the location sync service as a dependency. Let's test the application in the emulator now. When I click the start button, it prompts for location permission. Once allowed, you can see the coordinates displayed on the home page. I'm also sending location details using Redis stream. To test with the source code on Patreon, simply provide your Redis connection string in MAUI program class. You can see the changing coordinates if you run this on a real device while traveling. In the next video, we'll implement real-time location viewing in a Blazor web app. Support us on Patreon by joining our community. Community members gain access to source codes, early access, and other exclusive content. If you find this video helpful, please like, share, and subscribe to the channel. See you in the next video. Thank you.